Today I'm going to show you how I made the skater vision video. Most of these effects are pretty low budget, easy to do, and lead to some pretty cool shots, so check it out. The first transition was done completely in post by just keyframing the position and scale so that the camera zoomed into his eye. This combined with the whip pan camera movement made for a nice blinking effect. The next transition was another whip pan. The hardest part about this shot was choreographing it so that the whip pan happened at about the same time for both shots. Since we were riding on skateboards and it was nearly impossible to match the movement perfectly each time, a little work had to be done in post to retime and reposition so that they lined up correctly. And then I just added a little simple mask so that he would appear in the frame twice to really sell the effect. The next clip was actually the easiest to pull off since we had a pop-up green screen. First, I had Lucky do his tricks on the left and right side of the screen. Once we got both tricks, it was just a matter of masking them together to give the cloning effect and have him appear in two different spots. Finally, we added our top layer of him standing in front of the green screen. This one was just simply masking out the green screen, using key light to key it out, and then we have our finished shot. The hardest shot to get was the under the bridge shot. First, we recorded Lucky ollieing the stairs, and then I panned up to the top. Keeping the camera in the same position, I had Lucky run back up and walk across the frame in front of a green screen. I wanted Lucky to appear before the camera stopped moving. To do this, I used motion tracking to track the pole where he would be walking, and then just parent his layer to the tracked layer so that he would be moving with the shot. Then I just keyed out the green screen, and then we had our finished shot. The last shot was the handrail shot. To achieve this, we used a revolve motorized dolly, which is perfect for travel because it can run on PVC pipe and pack down really light. This allowed us to get the exact same camera movement every time, which would make things a lot easier in post. Since the two shots were identical, all it took was a simple mask and the two shots blended together seamlessly. So I hope this inspired you to use some of these effects in your own videos. If you like what you see, I'll be releasing new content every week, so make sure to subscribe and leave a comment below letting me know what you'd like to see. Thanks for watching, see you next week.